Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, today I'm going to talk about something called as the ACTG, Global Network Trial. This is a new initiative in 2025. It will be quite a brief video, but again, everything that we hear about any small development that's happening in HIV research towards a cure, I think is important news for each and every one of you. So I hope you'll be watching this till the end. It'll be a short video, it won't take too much time. With that said, please check out the disclaimer and then we'll proceed further. Welcome back, friends. ACTG stands for AIDS Clinical Trials Group. It's a global network of researchers that focus on HIV and a few other infectious diseases. They recently announced the opening of a new clinical trial called ACACIA. The full form of that is antiretrovirals combined with antibodies for HIV-1 cure in Africa. This phase 2 double-blind randomized study is designed to evaluate the safety and effectiveness of two long-acting broadly neutralizing antibodies, which we call as BNABs. Specifically, the first one is 3BNC117-LS, and the second one is 10-1074-LS. The trial will enroll 135 adults living with HIV in four African countries, which are Botswana, Malawi, South Africa, and Zimbabwe. The participants must be HIV positive and not yet receiving HIV treatment. After starting an integrase inhibitor-based ART regimen, participants will be randomly assigned to receive either a single intravenous infusion of both 3BNC117-LS and 10-1074-LS or a placebo. Placebo means something that has got no effect on the body, but the patient may believe that it is a medicine. It will look like the medicine, but it's nothing. So they're going to do the blind test out there. Now let's try to understand these two BNABs, the broadly neutralizing antibodies. 3BNC117-LS and 10-1074-LS are laboratory-made versions of naturally occurring antibodies that can block HIV from infecting cells. They are called broadly neutralizing antibodies because they can neutralize a wide range of HIV strains. This is basically possible because they are targeting the conserved regions, and the conserved regions are less mutated among various strains. 3BNC117-LS targets a specific site on the HIV envelope called the CD4 binding site. This site is crucial for HIV to attach to and enter immune cells. By binding to this site, 3BNC117-LS prevents HIV from infecting those cells. 10-1074-LS targets a different area of the HIV envelope called the V3 loop. This loop also plays a role in HIV's entry into cells. By binding to the V3 loop, 10-1074-LS further hinders HIV's ability to infect cells. The LS in their name indicates that these are long-acting versions of the antibodies. This means they are designed to stay in the body for an extended period of time, potentially offering sustained protection against HIV. By combining these two BNABs, researchers are hoping to achieve a more potent and durable effect against HIV, potentially leading to long-term viral suppression even without continuous ART. Because these antibodies are expected to remain in the body for many months, researchers will wait 15 months before stopping ART treatment in patients who have undetectable viral loads and sufficient immune cells. Participants will be closely monitored for the next 24 weeks to see if the BNABs can control the virus without medication. If successful, this could be a major breakthrough in finding a cure for HIV. The ACACIA study complements other ACTG trial called POS, which is evaluating similar antibodies in people already taking ART. So friends, that is the scoop for 2025. We are just into the first month of 2025. We have not even done the 20 days yet. It's the 22nd of January. So we just around the last part of January, and we already have a good announcement. So this should be motivating for most of you. So I hope that these tests are able to succeed and we are able to get something that is hopeful by the end of the year in terms of study results, so that it can be taken further into actual therapy that can go into arms of patients and give them more options and better relief, sustained relief for a long period of time. And friends, before I could wind up this video, I want to give you a few more information. Our channel is basically probably the only channel that tries to take scientific literature on HIV research, therapy research, and bring it to you in layman's form, explaining it in a simplistic way. But it should not be mistaken to be medical advice, because I am not a doctor. I am just giving you information that I have taken from these research papers from respected sites, and converting them into easily understandable language so that each and every one of you can have an understanding of what is happening in HIV research, how far away is the cure. Many of you ask me in the comment section, when is a cure coming? The honest answer to that is that even the scientists do not know when the cure is coming, because these things are very difficult to game out. The clinical trials can take a longer period of time, and the clinical trial enrolls a bunch of patients, and it needs a good sample size in order to prove to FDA that the therapy or medicine is effective. And those sample size people should survive the entire clinical trial and constantly provide blood samples and take the medicine as required by the regimen. And only then can the entire clinical trial cycle complete successfully. Having completed successfully, the next hurdle is that the data that comes out from a successfully completed clinical trial should demonstrate safety, efficacy, and should be better than or equal to something else that is in the market for the same ailment. In this case, we are talking about HIV. So it's a tall order and it's difficult, but people are working round the clock, so take heart on that. And in this new year, this is a new initiative kicking off, or at least I found this information this year, and therefore I think that it's a good start for the new year. And friends, if you like this kind of contents, please press the like out there. If you're already a member, thanks to you. If not, please encourage others to become a member and help us grow this channel. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.